some heavy breathing in the ears here.
We're just fat.
Fat.
I'm sitting down.
Well, guys, welcome back. It's been a bit of a minute. How long has it been? 7 months?
It's May.
Yeah,
Mid-May.
So, long time since we've actually recorded a video, but we're in new grounds today. We're actually in my home gym, which is Warehouse in Aberdeen. And we're going to be performing a push session, but predominantly shoulders and triceps with a little bit of chest thrown in. And Andy's just going to be following along.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But give us a little bit of intro about what you've been up to recently.
So that's me 11 weeks out today from the Arnold Classic USA. So yeah, I came off the back of that Arnold UK prep. And then after about 2 minutes of eating and getting my energy back up, I realised I wasn't done yet. So decided to jump back into a prep 5 weeks later. So yeah, we're 11 weeks out. Probably get you to have a look at me at the end, just to kind of see how things are looking. But train's flying just now. Obviously, it's good to come back here because this is where I used to train back in the day, like eight to 10 years ago. And obviously, it's changed massively since then. It's now way more catered to kind of people like us. So I'm excited to kind of get a good push session out because we've not actually recorded one. We've done two leg, a back, and two back and two leg.
Two back, yeah.
So I'll be interested to kind of get an insight into what we do push-wise.
The gym here has just been refitted with all new Panatta kit with a lot of some Cybex, and there's a couple of hammer strength things we've been adding with all the original Nautilus stuff that's here. So we've got quite a good selection of all the new kit we actually want to show everybody. But obviously with shoulders, it's not going to be too much of the kit-wise and stuff. But hopefully we can get a few more sessions with the new kit involved. I'll definitely be filming some of my own content soon with the new kit. So hopefully that gets seen as well. But just give a little touch up on our past, what we've been doing 7 months. Obviously, the last time we filmed, we were both like maybe 2-3 weeks into prep, both into our journey to our qualifier, and then going into the Arnold Classic UK, which obviously we've both done. And I went and did the Denmark Amateur Olympia.
You can say you won, mate, it's fine.
I don't want to say I give too much of hype, you know what I mean? I did the Denmark Amateur Olympia 7 weeks after that. Coming up to 4 weeks post-show now. So yeah, that's me started into my recovery phase, off-season type thing, which I'll be probably running for a good year, my off-season this time, and just trying to improve what I feel like I'm lacking in areas at the moment. So it's going to be good just getting my Andy days. Obviously, we both enjoy our sessions together and we both push her quite hard. And I think my upper is probably the areas I would like to work most on. So I think the session is going to be quite good today, getting push her in that aspect of things. So hope you guys enjoy and... yeah, we'll see you in the gym. Starting off on the side laterals, which is going to be a drop set, a triple drop set. I'm going to be doing the dumbbells, and he's going to be doing the machine, just purely because he doesn't feel the dumbbells as much as he does the machine. And that's totally like just down to however you feel, think the exercise is better. If you feel dumbbells, do the dumbbells. If you feel machine, do the machine. Shouldn't just be one set thing for everybody. It should be totally designed around you and how you feel it the best. So probably start off with Andy on the machine. I'll do a little bit of warm-up on the dumbbells, and we'll come back and do the first set with him, then we'll go over to me.
So usually I train chest and delts separate. Obviously, following Greg's lead today, so happy to throw in some chest stuff as well.
If you're working this, the two of you, do you tend to go off and do your own thing, or do you?
No, this will just be one off.
Just for this one.
Yeah. I'll be coming over to be with him in the set, and then, like, you'll come over and do me, yeah.
Okay. He'll come over and do you.
Yeah.
You got on the mic.
Quote of the day. Will it drop 10 at a time?
Yeah.
It's cool.
Are you ready to go with your set, yeah?
All right, tight. Nice. Ooh. Nice. Ooh. Easy. Bang again. Hop. Bang. Heat. Let's go.
I've got it.
Bang again. Bang. One more. One more. Yes.
Got it.
You got it. Bang.
Yes.
Nice.
Fuck.
Nice. Do yourself 10.
Yeah.
Set up. 5, 4, 3, two, one, let's go.
Aye.
Yes.
Aye.
Oh, yes.
Aye.
And again.
With me.
Aye. Again.
Aye.
Half.
Plus.
Two.
Squeeze it.
Two.
Nice.
Yourself 10 again.
Yeah.
You've got this. Let's go. Bang them out.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Come on. Right, partials all day, let's go.
One.
Yes.
Two.
Three.
Squeeze.
Two. On the side, let's go.
Yes.
Good set. 25, sorry. And then I'll go to the 20s.
Right.
So I'll drop five a time.
Let's go then. Big shoulders, mate. Yep. Again. Smooth. Again. None. Again. 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 Good. Nice.
25, let's go.
Round two, mate. Here we go. Get in the zone. Yep. Again. Come on. That rhythm, mate. Score. Good. Come on. Yep. Nothing. Two more. Easy. One. Two. Good. Last round. Fucking focus on it, mate. Oh, date. Yep. Come on. Smooth, mate. Smooth. Come on. Power up. Go. More in a tank. More in a tank. Five with me. One. Yeah, partials. Two. Three. Four. Five.
Oh, yeah. Shit.
Nice, mate. Lovely job, boy.
I'm saying there's certain things we're all, but I think we're old enough and stupid enough now.
Aye.
To know if we can't push it, there's no point in trying, so I'm just a cousin injury.
There's still a wee bit of me that will go like that.
Fuck.
If he beats me.
If it's like a big whooping, it's like, fair enough. Just leave it there.
Ah, that's nice, that.
I usually do like 3.5 in the moment, but I'll see how my shoulder feels at 3.
No worries. They have to match, otherwise I go nuts.
All right, you've got it. Let's go.
Boom.
Boom.
Good.
Boom.
Solid, mate. Let's go.
Boom.
Come on, then.
Again.
All right. Let's go.
Boom.
Boom.
You.
I'm on then. Solid. Yes, yeah. Walk it there. Back we go. Yes. Set.
My boys do the same.
Go.
Cool.
Right. Mm. Big set, mate. Come on. Let's go for it.
Fuck. Jeez.
Nice set. Right.
Boom.
Good.
Boom.
Again.
Boom.
Working. Again.
Two.
Yeah.
Two.
Again.
Two.
Up.
Two.
Up. Yes, mate.
Two.
Come on. Again.
Back.
Drive. Got you. Get it. Yeah.
So, this is our back off set, but unlike the usual back off set, we're doing like a rest pause, so drop the weight a little bit. It's a rep range of 12 to 15. Once you feel like that, rest 30 seconds, go again, see what you can get in the next fucking load up. So we'll do that.
I go 2 and a 10, because I want to get the higher part of the rep range.
Some people don't like to go to the 100% what we're doing, so they could probably do 3 or 4 sets.
Yeah.
But we're putting like that much effort into one set. We can only do like a deload in the second set, so we'd never do the same weight again. We wouldn't get close to the reps we just got there if we did that again.
The only exercise I like would ever do more than 2 is in isolation. Yeah. If the specific goals
because it's such less of a taxing movement, aye. Whereas this, like, you're putting all your effort into like max load. But say like your way to do like side laterals for sets of 15, like you could do the same weight twice.
Aye.
Because it's a smaller muscle group, it's not the same intensity as pushing a heavy load.
Yeah.
So we can only do like this for 1 to 2 sets.
Right then.
Right then. Good reps.
Boom. Boom.
Easy, mate. Just keep that room close the eyes, keep the rhythm, let's go.
Boom.
Rhythm all day. all day, man. Burn them out.
Easy, here we go now. This is work. Work time, let's go. Come on, let's go. Let's get it. Again, there's two there.
Yeah.
Let's fucking go. One more.
Yeah.
Let's get it. Yes, yes. Okay, there, that's the one. Good.
Two.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10.
11. 10 to go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's get it, man.
Yes, Quinn.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, one there. Fight for it. Fight.
Yes.
Yes, good luck. Nice.
Fuck. Now my turn.
Hey, ready?
Yep.
We're going. Let's launch it.
Fuck!
Yes.
Game time, let's go.
Up.
Up. Yeah.
Up. Up. Up.
Nothing.
Up.
Again.
Up.
Working. That's you. That's you. Come on. Yep. That's easy, mate. Let's go. Let's go. Yep. Good, again. Up. Yes, come on. Five, up to the top. Up to the top. Yeah. Right, mate. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Game time, let's go. Yep. And drive. Yep. Working, come on. Yep. Yes, get that. Nice.
Ooh.
Brilliant. Nice one.
Ooh. There's no way I'm doing that again. So if we did more shoulders now, we'd probably be able to perform as much on the chest. So as long as we've done, like, we call those side lats a bit of a warm-up, really get the blood really into the muscle. That's our first heavy press. We want to move on to a chest press now, and then we'll move on to the rest of the shoulder. So we're just kind of hitting a little bit of chest, just really isolate and just obviously get a lot of the stimulus to that in a separate day. Where we'll have like another chest day, we'll do a little bit of shoulders as well. But now we'll just obviously hit a little bit of that and move on to the rest of the shoulders.
You need a chest pump for a Friday as well.
Good. That's pretty much the shoulders. Now we'll have triceps, skull crushers, and then we do single arm extensions. That'll be pretty much us done. So, triceps. Easy. Easy stuff. Strong, mate. Good. Again. Mumps. Yes, yeah. That we go, yes, good set. Good set. Two.
Yeah.
Two.
Hold on, and again. Yeah.
No.
Oh, get it?
I've got quite a lot of nerve damage with my shoulders, so if a movement doesn't feel right, once it starts to go, I'll just lose like all feeling in my shoulders and my pressing will just go to shit. So I'm just waiting to drop down the weight and see if I can get a better connection through that. It's just always happened. There's some weeks I feel good doing it, next week I don't, I'll lose all my power in pressing, so I'm actually quite lucky we've got to this point and it's actually just started to fatigue now. So I'll just drop the weight, I'll do my first set again, which is a lighter weight, and try to control it a bit better.
Tidy. Yeah. Yes, mate, come on. Bumble them again. Drive, one. Yeah, get it. That's good. What's the plan now?
So deloads, which is a rest pause, so a little bit lighter. So I want to get over 10.
Right, okay.
But you'll probably do 2.5 easy.
Aye. All day.
He's squeezing through the triceps.
Yeah.
Let's go, let's go. Last time, let's go.
Yeah.
One more, let's go. Yeah. We're touching it, we're touching it.
Yeah.
Yes, one, yeah. One.
Yeah.
Up, 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 up.
Yes, yes.
3, 2, 1. Up.
Yes.
U-bar, let's go. Tight, mate, tight.
10.
Again.
Yeah.
With me. Up.
Yeah. Yes. Here we go, mate.
3, 2. Yep.
Yep.
Right.
That's yours. Let's go. And drive. Yeah. Brilliant, mate. Yeah. Yeah. Go in. Yes, go in. Got you. Up we go.
Yeah.
3, 2.
Yep.
1. Launch it. Here we go. Last lap. Drive. Yeah. Yeah. Up. Get it. Nice. Good. That's you.
Come on then. Big drive.
Yes.
Last one. One more. You're working.
Yeah. Come on in. End the game, mate. Almost there. Yeah. 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 That's it.
So, final set, single arm extensions. I really find these so much better than using like a tricep rope or any accessory, just because you can have such control on either arm and get such a good squeeze at the bottom, nice little contraction at the top, but you can really feel each side the best. Because if you've got one side like it's a bit of lopsided or doesn't press the same, like I've got nerve damage this side, so obviously I've got more power on this. So I just like use each side to my own capability better. So I really like, prefer these over any other kind of tricep movement.
Hey, mate. Squeeze. Yeah. Down. Yeah. You're working. Squeeze. Good. Your body's still. Come on. Down. There it is.
Good.
Oh. Nice one. Yeah, mate. Lock and load. Here we go. Good. Come on in, down. Yep, get it. Nice, mate. Come on, squeeze it. That's you, mate. Give it a try. Nice.
Nice slow movement down, no power. Squeeze that muscle, that's it, that's it. You don't need power for these, you need big muscles, man. Come on, work it. That's the one. Squeeze from top to bottom. Contract, yes.
Again!
Yeah!
Yes!
Right. Yeah!
Here we
be! Mag!
Still you!
Yeah!
Again!
Mag! Yeah!
Again!
Yeah!
Good.
Well, guys, that's a wrap on push. Hope you guys could see the intensity me and Andy kind of take our sessions to and how well we kind of push her in the session. Like, we'll bounce really well off each other in sessions. We know when to come in, when we don't need to spot, the kind of just the little assistance that we need. It's not any massive force reps. We're trying to bang out 5 and we've only got 2. We're literally like got our fingertips on some of the stuff, just trying to really get that last little ounce of the muscle pushing the rest of it. There's nothing like really forcing in and it's not there. We're trying to excel our muscles to their maximum. Really good session. Hope you enjoyed my kind of session setup.
Yeah, like I don't usually do push sessions. I like to split delts and chest, but when you train a certain way, you can make anything work at the end of the day. Everything works. It's not just one particular system that works. So it was good insight for me to see kind of what you do push by. So
I kind of changed my ways last year because seen how much growth I could get from doing these kind of sessions. But you see today, it wasn't exactly a push-push. I mean, we threw in one chest exercise, but how we probably felt after that chest exercise, like that was pretty tough doing those 3 sets, yeah. 3 different variations through the set. By the time I finished that third set, my chest was, I could feel that was really fatigued, and to get that much like of a little bit of a stimulus in a session, so you're kind of breaking up your week. Obviously, I'm going to have a chest session maybe in about 3 or 4 days from now, which I'll do one shoulder exercise and that, and it'll just be like really side laterals, like the kind of same three set setup, and that's just going to be enough to kind of keep that going, kind of keep the blood in there, kind of keep that little bit of fatigue. That's all I really need to kind of push in the seat so I can split my sessions up. So it works well for me, might not work well for everybody else, but I can kind of get enough from that to get a lot of growth from a session. So that's just kind of how I set my things up now. But as I said, hope you guys enjoyed today. And we're going to have, hopefully, a lot more sessions kind of coming out now. We say this all the time, but we really are going to try and get a lot more content out. And obviously, you guys watch our podcast, well, hopefully you do. So we're going to try to get a lot more of them as well. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and we'll be back soon.
Before you sign off, like, just given the time of year, would it be appropriate to, in case it's ages before you are together again, like, briefly touch on your intentions for 2022 or the start of the first
I'll let you run up to your show, really, with your plans.
Well, yeah, like I said at the start, I'm 11 weeks out from the Arnold USA today, so obviously just had to look through everything just there. As much as like I've got Nick Vandal and Greg kind of in my corner, I can kind of gauge where I am as well. So I think I'm pretty ahead of where I need to be in terms of living
with it. I've looked at Andy obviously through both our preps. We both like share each other's progress photos. I mean, as much as we are competition in shows, we're still best friends. We still want to see each other win. As much as we battle out on stage, when the other person wins, the other person loses, it's just as great as a victory for either one of us, because we appreciate the hard work we both put in. So we share everything with each other, and I can see where Andy's at now compared to where he was last time. And just by looking at him, he's miles ahead last time. He looks in a much better place. He looks really fresh. He looks full. As I was just saying there, his legs are in better condition than probably would have been like 8 weeks out. He's at 11 weeks out now. So he's in such a good spot to kind of really, really bring his best in for the show. So I'm very excited to see that for him.
Yeah, so it's going to be exciting, to say the least.
For me, I said after my show, regardless if I won my last show, I was going to take this year off, because to jump from an amateur to a pro league, it's honestly night and day. As much as you could be an amazing amateur, once you see professionals, it's mind-boggling to their proportions, their symmetry, their condition, their size, what they can bring. So this year for me, I'm going to push that aspect of trying to get to a pro level. And then I can walk into an amateur show, really win pro card, and I can walk straight into a pro show without taking any more time off. So that's my goal this year. So I'm really hoping to take the next 12 months and just see where I can get in that space and time, and just take it from there. Like, you can't really plan ahead that much. You just need to see where it's going to go. But if I can have the same kind of year as I did last year, I've really found my groove of what works for me. So if I can have the same kind of year, I really do feel I'm going to be in a good spot for that. So that is my plans. Just that is the only plan right now. Just grow, get better, and just bring it into a pro level and see what I can do from there into the next year.
Yep.
But yeah, thank you guys for watching and stay tuned.
Nice one.
Class.
Awesome.